Yes, good evening, students. So we are waiting for everyone to join, and today we'll start the next topic, that is segmentation. Marketing research, I think we have completed in the last class. Okay. So let's start with the topic segmentation now. So waiting for, I think, 2 to 3 minutes, okay, for everyone to join, and then we'll start. So shall we start? I think, is there any doubt to anyone from the last session, please? Regarding marketing research, we have completed a topic in the last class. Any query, any doubt to anyone?
No, sir.
Oh. Okay, so let's start with the next and important strategical topic of your marketing management, which is called STP, segmentation, targeting, and positioning. These are the major three strategies which the company always use whenever they have to actually decide their target audience. They have to divide their target audience, and accordingly, which particular category of people they need to target in order to provide their product and services. Okay. So first of all, it's the most important, you could say, step, which is called STP, that is segmentation, targeting and evaluation, and positioning. Each and every three basic parameter of STP having the strategical importance in the organizational policies. Okay. Now, in this case, the first part we will discuss, that is segmentation. The second will start the targeting, and the last we'll start, that is positioning. Okay. So let's start with the first part and what actually the content which we will cover up in this particular unit. Let's start with the first part, that is about the market segmentation. Okay. Now, as you can see on my slide as well, we have just simply defined what is segmentation, what is targeting, and what is positioning. Okay. Now, what is the importance of this particular three basic parameter, three basic tools in order to successfully launch a particular product, in order to survive in the market, in order to compete with the competitors? All these important parameters will be the key ingredients for any company when we are talking about the strategic formulation. Okay, the first point is called segmentation. Now, in a simple language, if we understand what is segmentation, it is basically the various parameters or characteristics. On the basis of that, we can divide the market profiles. We can divide the population. We can segregate the population on the basis of company's target requirements or company's requirement. Okay, there are various, you could say, bifurcation, various dimensions, various, you could say, parameters. On the basis of that, we can bifurcate a population, which may be age, income level, occupation, gender. When we talk about, you could say, lifestyle, language, caste, religion, okay, economic status, each and everything counts when we discuss about market segmentation. So dividing a market on a particular parameter, on a particular ground, that is called your market segmentation. Clear, I think, everyone? The first point. Now, student, please kindly confirm. Market segmentation.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, sure. Second point is target marketing. What is targeting actually? For example, when we discuss about any company, okay, like for example, if I'm talking about Body Shop, Okay, Body Shop is basically providing the premium cosmetic range products. Okay, now definitely their segmentations are based on male, female, children. Okay, maybe their segmentation would be on age basis, maybe based on occupation, or maybe anything. Depends on the type of product or the offering is the company is providing to the customers. But when we discuss about the target, now, for example, let us suppose if the major target customer or so could say major segmentation of the Body Shop is the middle and upper middle class. Okay, that is segmentation. Now, under middle and upper middle class, what are the target audience they have? Like, for example, income level above 5 lakh, income level above 6 lakh, whatsoever. So, under segmentation, which particular target customer you will actually focus on, and accordingly you will launch the product. That is called target marketing. Clear?
Yes, sir.
And the last one is about market positioning. What is positioning? I think when we talk in a simple language, it is nothing but the image of a brand or a product in the mind of the customer. How a particular individual customer recognize a particular brand, recall a particular brand. Okay, so the image in the mind of the customer regarding a particular brand, regarding a particular service, regarding a particular, you could say, product, that is called, I'm really sorry, regarding, just a minute. Regarding a particular brand or a particular product, that is the part of your market positioning. Okay, so there's a major three equity strategy: STP, segmentation, targeting, and positioning. And one by one, we'll discuss all these three topics in detail now. Okay, any doubt, any query to anyone, please kindly confirm.
No. Namaste.
Sorry. So can I ask, sir?
Yeah, sure, Mr. Post, please.
Sir, I didn't really understood market segmentation and market positioning because both are looks like similar. I didn't really got the segmentation of these two.
Okay. I'll just explain you with an example. I think that would be far better for you to understand.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, when we discuss about, you could say, segmentation. Okay. For example, let us suppose we are talking about the Maruti Suzuki Nexa. Yeah. Okay. Now, Nexa definitely having certain market segmentation, market grouping, because, for example, they are launching Baleno, they are launching Xtrox, they are launching Xtrox, or any other variant. Okay. Definitely, their segmentation is, you can see the range of the product which start in Nexa is around 6 to 7 and above. Okay. So definitely their segmentation would be the income group, which is above 6 to 7 lakh. Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
That is segmentation. Now, for example, income group above 6 lakh, it means the limit is infinite. Okay.
Yeah,
now, above 6 lakh means up to what extent? So like 6 to 10, 6 to 12, and under 6 to 12, we might have a different category of customers. So under that range of, you could say, income level of 6 to 10 or 6 to 12, what should be their target market or what should be their target customer? That is targeting. Means you have selected a particular macro, then you have selected a micro. Time micro, I mean, that is about target. Okay. Now, positioning, I think you have also raised a question. Similar to Nexa, I think before launching Nexa, definitely we have certain preposition, certain position in the mind of the brand, that is Maruti. Even right now, if you talk about Indian, you could say, market, Maruti is basically having very distinguished image. Okay, when it's come to zero maintenance vehicle, okay, when it's come to very good resale value, okay, very good features, now they are coming up with Nexa. Okay, so what is the image of a particular product or a particular brand in the mind of the customer? That is basically the part of positioning. And always remember, the position of a brand always vary from person to person, country to country, locality to locality, or a particular income group to income group. According to that, they always prefer a particular brand over others. That is called the market positioning or brand positioning.
Okay, sir.
I hope so. Example is clear?
Yes, it's clear.
Shall we move, I think? Because now we have to discuss all these points one by one.
Okay, sir.
Now, let's start with the first part, market segmentation. I think I've already discussed this particular slide with you. Okay. That is dividing the market into homogeneous group. Homogeneous groups means based on similar characteristics, which may be age, income level, occupation, etc. Clear, everyone? I think we have already covered up all this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the major point which comes under segmentation, that is about the bifurcation or the basis or the grounds on which we can actually divide the markets. Okay. These bifurcation may be geographic, demographic, psychographic, and behavioral. Okay. So, on the basis of these four grounds, we can divide the market. Okay. Shall we start one by one? I think all these points.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with the first point right now. That is called geographic segmentation. Okay. Now, as I told you, that is whenever we are dividing a particular market on the basis of geographical unit, that may be a country, a city, a state, a region, a territory, an island, or maybe a group of countries. Okay. So whenever we are dividing a particular, we are dividing a particular market on the basis of geographical units, these basically the category or the point which comes under the segmentation or dividing the market on the basis of geographical segmentation or geographical units, we may say. Is it clear? Please kindly have a look of all these examples and the points. I think it's a very simple topic, but important one.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Sir.
Yes. Okay. Thank you so much. Now you can see that one more important concept, which is called geoclustering. What is geoclustering? Whenever we are segmenting or dividing a particular market on the basis of two characteristics in combination, that is geographical data and demographic data. Okay. So as per, you could say, you can see on my slide as well, whenever as per actually Nielsen Clariots, we have actually designed and innovated the concept of geoclustering. And geoclustering is basically nothing but the combination of geographical data with demographical data. And on the basis of that, we have actually defined the five major categories of segmentation. Okay, these categories are education and affluence, family life cycle, urbanization, race and ethnicity, and mobility. It's just a bifurcation which is given by Nielsen by innovating, by coming up with a new concept which is called geoclustering. And on the basis of that, we may actually divide the market, we may divide the population on the basis of these five major parameters. Hanji, any doubt, any query? Geographic segmentation.
No, sir.
Sir, can you please elaborate geo clustering once again?
Yeah, see, geo clustering is basically nothing but, as per Nielsen, he has actually innovated the concept that how the geographical, you could say, dimensions and demographical parameters combine together to actually come up with the five major heads, okay, that may define the geo clustering. Geo clustering means cluster or you could say group of population on the basis of bifurcation on grounds of geographical and demographic segmentation.
Okay.
Okay. And these are the five categories, includes your education and affluence, family life cycle, urbanization, race and ethnicity, and last one is mobility.
Understood. Thank you.
Fine. Thank you so much. Shall we move, I think, to the next part?
Yes.
Yes. Next one, we have demographic segmentation. I mean, the segmentation, dividing the market on the basis of demographic characteristics, which may be age life cycle, life stages, gender, income, generation, and race and culture. Okay. Very, very simple topic, actually, it is. Please have a look. Yes, students, I hope so. It is clear. We'll discuss all these points one by one in detail now, okay? The basic bifurcation is age and life cycle stages, life stages, gender, income, income and generation, race and culture, okay?
Sir?
Yeah, please.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please, tell me.
Sir, can you explain this last point? Usually the worst variable means...
Worst variable to use, it means that, like, because when we talk about, you could say, any segmentation, the important thing is that the company always need to target those population which are untouched or untapped. Okay. So any untouched or untapped market where the competitors is not focusing on providing their product or offering their product. Worst means doesn't mean in a negative sense, but it is mostly related to the untapped market.
Okay.
Any doubt to anyone?
Just want to check on the let's say we have a geographical location, and in that geographical location we have a market, let's say a smaller market, wherein we have further divided the market into demographic elements. And then we, let's say a city called Indore. I mean, in Indore, I have a different target audience. Now, if I have to divide the target audience, they would be under different demographic aspects, which are based on life, age, income level, et cetera, whatever you have mentioned as a gender, income, generation, race, and culture. Hello.
Yes, Diljit, continue.
Yeah, so I think it helps in... mapping for a product. Let's say if I launch a product in Indore and if I want to target an audience, I will further down and invade and find out and target these demographic segments to attract and make it more sellable aspect to it.
Definitely, yes. Because when we discuss about the strategy of any company for launching a product, we always actually go for integrated approach. Okay. That maybe like as we discussed about geo clustering. So demographic with geographic, we may use psychographic as well. We may use any other type of, you could say, dividation or segmentation, which may help the company to launch it more successfully. And the equitation is basically more impactful when it's come to brand image as well.
Certainly, sir. Thank you. I mean.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. So I think we'll discuss. We'll start discussing all these points one by one now. The first point is age and life cycle stages. We know that I think the different age group having their own requirement, having their own you could say demand or on need, we can say, when it's come to their life cycle and their age. Okay, according to the life cycle stages, definitely the requirement, needs and wants always changes. Okay, you can see that the requirement of this category of people or this category of, you could say, children, if we talk about teenagers, we talk about infants, we talk about. Okay, so wants and ability always changes with time. Their requirement changes, their priority changes, their product requirement, or you could say product preference changes, we may talk about. So life stages always play a very, very crucial role. And as you can see on my screen as well, different age group having different requirements. Okay, these age group might have a requirement of the beautiful, you could say, colored cloths, teddy bears, okay, chocolates, candies, toys. And according to that, the brands are always there in the market to attract them. Okay. Similarly, for a female, if we talk about the female and her life stage, actually, starting from the birth till the death, if we talk about how you can see that the life preference changes or the product changes or the brand changes or the requirement changes. And you can see that the age group, old age group or adult or teenagers, depends on the life cycle stages, actually, or life stage, or according to that, the preferences, requirement, their priorities always change. So age and life cycle stages always play very, very crucial role when it's come to requirements or wants of a particular set of people. Clear, I think, everyone?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next one, we have gender. Okay, I think it's a very simple topic. I'm not going to discuss much about that because as per gender, okay, which may be male, female or others, if you talk about, they have their own requirements, they have their own priorities, they have their own lifestyle, they have on their, they have on their fashion trends. Okay, according to that, the companies are basically targeting the gender as a parameter to bifurcate their product and service offerings. Okay, like we discussed, like the example of cosmetic industry, like Lakme, coming 9 to 5, major focus is for working women. We talk about Ustra, okay, we talk about Philips grooming range. We have different categories of customer to influence or to attract. Clear, I think, everyone? Very simple point.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, please. Kindly, yes or no? Shall we move to the next part? I think so. Then.
Yes, sir.
Well, I think there is no point to discuss. According to the income level, your shopping preference, your clothing preference, your food preference, your travel preference, your fine services preference, your investment preferences, your automobile preferences, n number of, list is endless, actually. So just give me a minute, actually. I have to take the water. Just a minute. So I think on the base of income, we have certain bifurcation, and income always play a very, very crucial role when it's come to categorization or bifurcation of your target customer. Hanji, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Let's move to the next part now. That is called generation. Now, generation, we are talking about in decades actually right now. Okay. You can see that the generation of 1990s might be my generation if I'm talking right now, having very different attitude and the way how we are living our life. Same if you talk about Mr. Anuj, I think having different generations, having their own requirement and own attitudes. Okay. Similarly, if you talk about the females belong to different generation, having their own attitude and way of life, and their basics, their ethics, their values, their morals are also very different. According to that, definitely companies also target the particular generation or a age group or a particular decade group, if you talk about. According to that, the product may be launched or product may be upgraded as well. Okay, so that is called the generation is one of the, again, important parameter to be considered. Haan ji, is it clear?
Yes.
Haan ji. Let's move to the next part, please. That is called race and culture. Okay. Now, race and culture is race is basically is all about the ethnicity. We talk about, you could say, the customs, the traditions, the life settlement, if we talk about. And more about when we discuss about the race and culture, it is important parameters about the dynamics of society. Or dynamics of, you could say, environment in which you are surviving or in which you are living actually. You may actually experience all these differences when we talk about the culture and the people and the lifestyle which we talk about the people of, you could say, Delhi, Mumbai, having very different lifestyle. We talk about Bangalore, having very different lifestyle. We talk about a particular, you could say, semi-urban or urban city or you could tier two city, having very different race and culture and you could say lifestyle. Okay, so according to this ethnicity, the culture, the sense of, you could say, living their life, the way they are actually managing their cycle, each and everything counts. Again, when we talk about the offering which is given in different cities and different countries or different states in the world. Okay, like we always talk about the European culture, we talk about Western culture, okay. Then we talk about eating habits, we talk about dressing habits, we talk about the festivals which we celebrate. Everything is now getting transformed from one country to other country. There may be some hybrid form as well, which we're talking right now. These are the, you could say, some important parameters which the company need to analyze and assess before actually going for commercialization or launching of any product and services. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next one, I think the next category I think we are talking right now, that is called psychographic segmentation, third category we are talking right now. Okay. So psychographic segmentation, basically like when we are dividing or bifurcating the population on the basis of, you could say, values, morals, lifestyle, attitude, okay, about their more about psyche, okay, more about their internal characteristics, internal way of living their life or how they approach their life, okay, it is more about psyche or psychographic segmentation. Now, these segmentation are basically characterized in the marketing term that is called personality traits, according to type of personality. Definitely, person may choose or may opt a particular product based on lifestyle and based on the value, belief, morals, ethics of a particular individual. So these are the parameters which comes under psychographic segmentation.
Okay, sir.
Everyone, please. I think yes, topic is very simple and clear. I think.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So just need a little examples.
Okay.
If you can elaborate on that.
Definitely. Like psychographic?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. Like when we discuss about in the Indian culture itself, we have different lifestyle from the people of South, people of North, people of East, people of West. Okay. Their psyche is very different. Their belief are very different. Their way of life is very different. Their, you could say, custom traditions are very different. Okay, and according to that, you can see that their, you could say, demands, you could say the companies even are approaching as per the different regions. If you talk about when they offer their product into particular locality, okay, we talk about, you could say, religious values of different you could say territory in India itself. If you talk about, are very different. South, if you once will move to Kerala, the things and the way the people offer their prayers are very different compared to UP, compared to Jammu, compared to Delhi, compared to South. If you talk about, like we talk about Karnataka, having very different way how they actually celebrate their festival, how they actually the ethnic sense, if we talk about when it's come to their dressing sense, is also very different on a particular occasion. So psyche is basically is all about their lifestyle, all about their values, their beliefs, their morale, their grounds. Everything, you could say, counts when we talk about company's strategy towards a particular locality or towards a particular set of people.
Right, sir.
And there are so many things we can cover up, okay? Because if we discuss even on the psychographic segmentation, we need at least hours of discussion. So there are so many things which we can cover up, but just like keeping in consideration about the time limits, we are just going step by step to the next topics. Clear? I think everyone?
Yes, sir.
Graphic. Yeah, sure. Thank you so much. Next one now. Behavioral segmentation. Okay. Now, behavioral segmentation based on basically three major parameters. The first one is decision role, user and usage, and needs and benefits. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the first part, the behavioral segmentation, this is basically all about the uses and the frequency of uses and the pattern of uses of particular product and services. Okay. Now, if you talk about needs and benefits, okay. Like for example, if you talk about drinking habits, alcohol, okay. The different people or different set of, you could say, population having their different, having their, you could say, motive behind whenever they are going for, you could say, drinks or going for alcohol. Okay. Needs and benefits or the approach or the purpose behind having drinks in the night or drinks on a particular occasion, it may differ. Like we talk about the people of Punjab, especially if we talk about the level of, you could say, or the consumption of alcohol is the percentage you everyone knows about. When we talk about, you could say, any other state, the consumption level or the way how the people actually enjoy their weekends when it comes to alcohol, the benefits, the purpose, the frequency, the occasion always matters a lot. Okay. And according to that, the population always knows that what is their basic purpose behind, you could say, red wine, behind whiskey, behind vodka, or what, or behind beer, if you talk about. This is the needs and benefits we are talking right now. And according to that, a particular population set may approach a particular product or a brand.
I think, sir, Punjab is very stereotypically taken to be highest consumption of alcohol. Mm-hmm. But in, I think, Gujarat is more internally.
Even Karnataka, the south is very high, actually.
True. Kerala and Karnataka.
Yes. It's very high, actually. So, just an example. I'm not going to target any state or any, like, for example, I'm just...
Just a stereotype. You know, I think people have that notion.
This is what happened, actually. Like, whenever we talk, give an example, people take it personally. And like, being a faculty, it's my duty just to actually touch the different aspect of the examples or the quotes which I'm just putting forward over here. Okay.
Got it, sir.
Yes. Because being a faculty, you have to very, very particular about your words, your your sense, like in what context you're talking right now. just a minute, student. I think I'm facing a lot of dry throat today. Santosh, I think you're talking something. You want to raise some question?
There is one thing I'm getting confused, like, because psychic character, which we mentions has like similar group or similar character group.
Mm-hmm.
And behavioral segmentation, you're talking about needs and benefits. Like, I am feeling like both are similar. Can't we?
No. Actually, see, culture may affect needs and benefits. Psyche may be associated with behavioral, but there are certain, you could say, thin line differences like when we talk about all these points. For example, I think you were talking about this values, lifestyle, and personality. Like according to lifestyle, your needs and benefits may affect.
That differ, agree.
Yes, yes, sir. Understood, I think. But for example, like the example which I quoted, like the nightlife of, you could say, Bangalore, nightlife of Mumbai, you cannot compare with Indore. So that is an example because their needs, their benefit, their requirements are very different. And their way, how they enjoy their life is very different. Their you could say, spending pattern is very different. Their purchasing power is very different. Okay. So according to that, according to, you could say, by integrating all the factors, we all need to understand and you could say implement, or we need to plan the strategies from the company's point of view accordingly.
Okay.
I hope so. Santosh, clear, na?
Yeah.
Yes. Shabana, I think please don't write anything on the screen. Okay. Let me, I think. Okay. So needs and benefits, I think it's clear. Yes. Next one, we are going for, you could say, decision rule now. 1 minute, please. Yes. Next one, we are going for decision rule. Now, in the case of decision rule, you can see that there are certain category of buyer or certain category of respondent towards a product are available in the market. You can see the five categories: initiator, influencer, decider, buyer, user. Okay. Now, when we talk about decision rule is basically a particular individual always play these five types of roles in his or her life. Like, for example, I'm a hardcore iPhone user. Whenever, like the moment the iPhone 12 was actually launched in US, immediately I booked it. Irrespective, what should be the response or what should be the, you could say, feedback and reviews of iPhone 12. I am the initiator because I am the first one who actually booked that particular mobile phone. Influencer. Who are influencer? For example, if I'm using, you could say, one Apple iPad, for example, and I'm very, very happy with that pencil, actually, with the help of that, I can draw, I can solve the numerical on my screen. I'm the influencer. To whom I'm influencing? To my colleagues, to my faculty colleagues, if I talk about, okay, to my, you could say, friend, those who are in this field. I'm the influencer. Because of my uses of the product, I can actually enforce them to purchase a similar product. Okay. Decider means, in a family, like everyone knows about that, decider means ultimate decision maker in a company or in a family or in your personal life as well. Who is your back support? Who is your, you could say, near and dear ones with whom you always interact, you with whom you always consult about any decision making of your life, of your company, of your organization, of a country as well, if you talk about. Okay. Buyer, I think very simple, and user is the ultimate consumption which is being done by a particular individual or a particular company or a particular country. That is called decision rules. I hope the examples are clear.
Yes, sir.
Next one, now we have the last category, that is user and usage. Okay. Now, user and usage, you can see that the first point is all about how we are actually using, in what frequency we are using, in what quantity we are using a particular product. The first one is called your usage occasion. What does it mean? The frequency. Or not frequency, actually, the occasion or the purpose for which we are arranging a party, we are arranging a cocktail, we are arranging, you could say, a function, we are arranging, you could say, one seminar, occasion, we are donating, we are helping in the NGOs, whatsoever it could be, usage occasion. User status. When we discuss about the user, you could say status, it is basically all about whether you are, you could say, non-user, okay, whether you are talking about, you could say you are a frequent user, or you are, you could say, very you could say loyal user of that particular product or services. Okay, so depends on the type of user, according to that user status towards a particular brand or product may be associated. For example, like I am using only Apple products in my life. When it's come to mobile phone, when it's come to television, even like I always use, when it comes to desktop, everything, I have Apple. So I am the loyal user, or you could say heavy user of Apple products. Like similarly, if I'll take an example, if I'm talking about, you could say, any, you could say, product when it's come to your kitchen. Okay, like I'm very fond of you could say different chocolates. Okay, and for Dairy Milk, you could say caramel flavor, for example, I'm the hardcore user of that. So that is about the brand loyalty, which actually reflects from my side towards the consumption level or the user status towards that particular brand or toward that particular product is very, very high. That is called user status. Okay. Users, usage rate means the frequency of use, the frequency of use, how often you purchase, how often you consume, daily, weekly, monthly, hourly, whatever it could be, that is called usage rate. When we talk about buyer readiness, what is buyer readiness? It is basically is all about the stage where buyer is ready to dispose of his or her money to purchase the product. It is called buyer readiness. Okay, for example, like if I'm planning to purchase, you could say electric cycle, for example, and I'm actually searching over, you could say, Flipkart, Amazon, or even different websites which are available for the same. I'm searching since last 1 week or 1 month, but now I'm ready to buy because I have a financial capacity to purchase that. Okay. And loyalty status we already covered. Okay. I hope so. These 5 points are clear.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Shall we move, I think, to the next slide, if it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, I think the example which I have just given it to you about loyalty status, about occasion, about benefits, about usage rate, I think the examples and detail it is mentioned over here. Just have a look. I think occasion, benefit sorts, and usage rate, I think we already covered up. What about loyalty status? I think there are 4 major points I think we have, which are different, I think, which we didn't discuss yet. Any doubt in this occasion, benefit sort, and usage rate, please?
Sir, please explain loyalty status once.
Yeah, I'll discuss that, okay? So loyalty status, as I told you already, that how you could say brand conscious or brand loyal, or what is your status when it's come to, like, for example, if I want to purchase Nestle Maggi, and once I visited D-Mart, and if I didn't find the, you could say Nestle Maggi, let's say Atta Maggi, for example, I purchased some other brand of Maggi. Am I brand loyal? No. Because I'm a switcher. Okay, so I'm a switcher, or I may be shifting loyal, or I may be split loyal. Iska matlab kya hota hai? Like, we'll discuss one by one now. Okay, now the first point, it is called hardcore loyal. It means that I am the, you could say, one of the individual, or one of the, you could say, family member, or one of the, you could say, family, we always use a particular brand of product only. If it is not available, we will not switch to any other alternative brand. That is called hardcore loyal. okay, who always buy only one brand all the time, no changes at all.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, like for example, if I am using in my personal care, I am using Nivea and its products. Okay, so Nivea is a particular brand which I am using since long. And if, like, for example, Nivea body wash, or you could say Nivea, you could say moisturizer is not available, I will not switch to any other brand. That is called hardcore loyal status.
Okay, fine.
Now, split loyal. Split loyal means when I am loyal to two or three brands at a time. Okay, for example, like I am very fond of using different, you could say, shower gel. Okay, I daily want, someday I need Nivea, someday I Palmolive, someday I need, you could say, Pears or whatsoever. Because it is basically the loyalty of a particular person towards not a single brand. He may use multiple brands in parallel. Okay, like similarly, like it happens with so many people when it's come to this perfumes or you could say deodorants. We always use multiple actually options for weekend parties. We have different options. For office, we have different options. For evening parties, we have different options.
Right.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Next one, we have shifting loyal. Okay. Shifting loyals are basically like we shift from one brand to another brand very, very easily. Like same example of Nestle Maggi. Okay. So Nestle Maggi is not available. I go to the Top Ramen. Okay, or whatever, you could Sunfeast Maggi, whatsoever, what the different brands available. That is called shifting loyal. Like mm-hmm. for example, in the month of April, if I visited to DMart, I purchased you could say Top Ramen noodles. And now next month May, if I'll go and again I'll find Nestle, I'll purchase Nestle rather to go for the previous brand. That is called shifting loyal. And switchers, they are not at all loyal for a particular brand. If they are getting discount even on a particular product which is not at all fashionable, you will actually switch because you are not at all 1% loyal towards a particular brand. You will easily switch. You will easily influence with the marketing tactics of other companies. It is called switchers.
Understood,
I think everyone.
Thanks.
Anji. Is it clear, everyone? I think these 4 points we have covered up actually.
Yes, sir.
Then the next one is all about consumer attitude. It's a very simple point. Okay, like for example, don't take it personally, please, everyone. Okay, there are different people having their different eating habits. Okay, there are few people who may be vegetarian, who may be non-vegetarian as well. If I talk about KFC, might be, you could say, we have around 20, 21 students in the class. They have a different mindset or different perception towards chicken or towards non-veg, you could say, menu options or non-veg options available in the market. Maybe hostile, very, very aggressive, very negatively aggressive, actually. Very negative, very indifferent, positive mind, or enthusiastic. Okay, so attitude of a particular person towards a particular brand. Like, for example, it's very common conversation, like even like in our family, in the workplace, or even if among friends, like whenever we need to go for a movie or any, you could say, theater, or any, you could say, for dine or whatever it could be, we have certain expression actually. Like, for example, if you call to your friend, like, where's the party tonight? So they will give the option to you. Okay, let's go to this particular mall. Let's go to this particular restaurant. You will react accordingly. It's very, very common. It's very, very, you could say, natural actually, from the point of view of a particular person. He or she will react on a particular option. Like, for example, let's go to the Pizza Hut and I'm a pizza lover. It would be very enthusiastic and very positive for me. But if I'm not a pizza lover, it may be negative or hostile as well. Clear?
Yes, sir.
I think this is not required to discuss. I think it should just need a break. I think it badly needed for me. Okay, so we'll get back to you at 7 o'clock sharp and we'll continue with the topic. Okay. Okay, students, so we'll get back to you at 7 now.
Sure, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, student. So I think we should start now. The users and loyalty status of segmentation. Okay. Now this particular, you could say chart, if you can see on my screen, this particular chart is based on, you could say, how the company is basically creating and segregating their customer on the basis of the different, you could say, status of user or customer for a particular brand or a particular product. Now, if you talk about the first point, target market. Is the target market aware or unaware? If it is unaware, definitely you need to find out what is your target market. Okay. If it is aware, definitely whether the product is being tried or not tried yet. If it is not tried, why it is not tried? Because the customer may have a negative opinion, may have a neutral opinion, they do not want to purchase, or they are 50-50 in that. May have a favorable opinion, but they didn't try the product yet. Okay, they have tried, but they have rejected. They not yet repeated. They do not want to repeat the product, or they want to repeat the product because they are loyal to the particular product. If they are repeating, why they are repeating? Either they are loyal to brand, either they are switcher, or either they are you could say loyal to other brands. Okay, or if you are loyal to the brand, how frequently you use that brand? Either you are a light user, medium user, or a heavy user of the product. Okay, so that is basically the part of your loyalty towards the brand, and this is segment of the structure through which we can segment a particular market based on different characteristics. Clear, I think, everyone?
Yes.
Now, when we discuss about the last two slides and last two topic of this segmentation topic, now you can see that the requirement for effective segmentation, definitely whenever we are dividing the market, it must possess these five basic characteristics. Okay, that the segmentation must be measurable, means you must know size of the market, their purchasing power, their profile, means their occupation status or their family cycle, their family structure. So these are the major, you could say, points which comes under measurable category. Okay. Second is accessible. Accessible means to whom you are targeting for your product or for your services. That particular customer base should be easily approachable. That is called accessible. Okay. Substantial. Whatever target market you have, whatever target audience you have, these target audience should be profitable, or this target audience should give the utmost profit or sufficient profit or returns to the company in the long run. Differential. Okay. Now, whatever you could say target market you are looking after or you have selected for your product, okay, they must have different choices of product selection, different product mix, different product line to select, so that they would be retained with the customer for a longer period of time. Okay, and the last one is actionable. Actionable means your product must be attractive, your branding must be attractive, your packaging should be attractive, and how the company is basically promoting their product, it must catch the emotional aspect of the people, or you could say with the a person to whom you are targeting for. So that is about the requirement for effective segmentation. Any doubt to anyone, please?
No, sir.
Perfect.
No, sir.
Last slide now. I think we have already covered up this particular points. Basis of segmentation when we come to business market. Okay. So like that is similar to B2B, that is business to business. We are talking about, you could say, operating variable, which will be technology, user status, or customer capabilities. Purchasing approach, what is the power structure in purchasing power? What is the existing relationship of the particular, you could say, two businesses? How actively they are dealing with each other? Situational factor depends on urgency of the goods, specific application, size of the order. According to that, the order may vary. And the last one is personal characteristics. Okay, that may be based on buyer-seller similarity, loyalty status, risk attitude. So these are the basic five segmentation for business to business market segmentation. Okay. And that's all about segmentation actually. Haji. So I think we have covered up the major four points of segmentation: demographic, psychographic, behavioral, and geographic. Okay. These four points are there. Any query in segmentation, please, to anyone?
No, sir.
Now, targeting will start from tomorrow. Targeting positioning will cover up tomorrow. Now we are just discussing one case study of HSBC Bank regarding segmentation and targeting. Okay. So I think I have already shared this ebook with everyone. So the page number, if you have the ebook, it's okay. If not, definitely you can see my screen right now. The Kotler book I have already shared with you all. The page number we have, that is of 237. And the case of marketing excellence, that is of HSBC Bank. If not, definitely you can focus on my screen as well. Okay, students, so we are starting this case now of HSBC. If you have the book, please, you can just refer it and we can discuss. Okay, so 5 minutes of time for this slide, please, 5 to 7 minutes. 7:15, I think we'll change the slides. Okay, let's go through with it, please. We'll discuss about their strategies of HSBC.
Sir, is this only one page?
No, no, no. We have one more actually. I'm on the last paragraph. Just a minute, please. Okay. Just a minute.
Okay.
Then I think everyone with the first page.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Yes.
So first page, give us another 1 minute, please.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. Now we can change the slide.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. The second slide, please. Okay. Yes, done everyone, I think. Shall we wait? should be once done, let me know. Okay, so we can move further.
So are we going to discuss about this case or?
Yes, only summary and the major points like regarding the case study. That's all. Done everyone, I think.
Yes.
Okay.
So I think as what I discuss, I have to go on through, because the major tagline about like getting close to their customer when it's come to HSBC Bank, that is about the world's local bank. And as you can see that how innovative, how differentiated products which they are launching, and they are always very, very concerned about like keeping in consideration about the local taste and preferences. Okay. So according to that, I think they have a very good program regarding pets insurance. They are providing some, you could say, product related to, you could say, cards to the students of that particular country.
Smart cards,
yes. And along with that, they have, you could say, certain issues or challenges which they face. Then there was an outbreak of SARS in 2003. Okay, that is a major important point which is being covered up in this. Okay. Like they were also discussing about their advertisements and their values, how they actually approach to their customers, how simplified and how grounded their advertisement around the ranking. Actually, in the last paragraph, it is given that how these companies are basically associating when it's come to its brand value day by day. Okay. Or how they can, definitely you can see the second last paragraph will improve $10.5 billion brand value, which plays a 32nd on the 2009 Interbrand Business Week Global brand ranking. Okay. So basically, as you can see that this case is more about positioning actually. Okay. Because how the HSBC is creating their brand value among their customers. And not only actually because they have a major target is a niche market they are targeting actually. And how the companies are basically defining their strategies accordingly. Okay. So any summary from your side, please, students? I think this is what I understood from the case. Yes, student, anyone, please. Any summary from your side and regarding these two questions now? So am I audible? I think so. This is what actually.
Student, please kindly confirm. I think, is this case clear to everyone? I think it's very, very simple case regarding positioning of the HSBC in the world market.
Basically, sir, HSBC is the depending on the customer market. Hello?
Yes, yes, please, please.
Hello?
Yes, no, please, please, continue.
Sir, basically...
I think MIA2, please kindly wait for a few minutes. Anuj, come, can you please continue?
Exactly, no, I joined late. Can yes. you again please explain a little bit?
Okay, you go ahead. You go ahead, no problem.
No, actually, Mr. Anuj, he joined late.
Mr. Anuj, he joined
late. Okay, you can continue, Mr. Anuj, please.
Basically, this HSB bank is depending on the customer values. And as per his values, he's getting the position in the market. And this case history is showing, but he also take care about the risk. First question is risk cover. Then this will be see the financial funding itself for the HSB.
Okay.
And he's always give the best possibility to the customer always. And I think so because of the customer values. And he's HSBC bank fulfill always, then from the customer size is more appreciable. I think so. And second one is the most recent company. And he's and HSBC bank already see the customer local banks criteria also.
Yes, definitely, yes.
And according to that, he will give the offers on the smart cards and other things and so many things. But risk cover is only the funding of the initial funding of the bank. It is if gone, sometime is gone down, then it is the problem for the bank.
Yes.
Then he will manage overall.
Yes, definitely. Because see, then, that, yes, Mr. Anush, please, sorry. Yes, continue.
Then according to that, now position of the HSBC bank is nowadays also is good.
Okay.
See, this is my conclusion, sir.
Yes, definitely. Because see, student, try to understand because it's not possible just to cover up the case completely with each and every point. The important thing is that the base of the case is very important to understand this.
Yes. And basically is the point. What is the basic point for this case study? If you go the base point, then it is the conclusion.
Definitely. Sir.
No, nobody bank gives own amount to the customer. Because this is the business.
Yes,
but definitely. See the market values, markets, local bank criteria, and also all the things. And a part of them, he will also see the funding value of the itself. It is not gone below the level. If gone below the level, then bank gone down.
Yes.
This is the risk factor. But he will manage all of them. It is appreciable.
Definitely. And that's the reason, like, I think you can see that it is the world's second largest bank in right now when it's come to their operation, when it's come to their customer base. Okay, it's
yes,
the most premium bank in the world right now. And
actually giving their funding, giving their, you could say, sponsorship to different sports activity, different arena, if you talk about. That is again one of the most commendable, actually, cultural program. I think it is written that 250 cultural and sporting events they have sponsored actually till the time. 9 key, I think, where it is right now.
Same as India, sir. This is the HDFC Bank is also going the same criteria. Do you see the HDFC is also give the most opportunity to the customers?
Yes.
Nowadays, HDFC is going the same formula. But this is the World Bank, this is the only Indian bank, but going same phenomena.
Yes, sir, Mr. Good. Thank you so
much. Sir, what's the meaning of resonate in question 2? Campaign resonate with its target audience?
Does SNBC most recent campaign resonate with its... Resonate means related, actually. Means whether the particular, you could say, campaign which they started, whether it is associated, or you could say whether it is helpful for the company to create their position or brand image in the mind of the customer. Means associated, we can say, or related, we can say.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, students. So I think...
Okay, thank you so much.
Tomorrow, I think I'll start with targeting and positioning, and we'll discuss one more case study of BMW. Okay. How the BMW has actually settled their position in the mind, global market. Okay, that point will start tomorrow, along with targeting and positioning will complete tomorrow. Okay. Yes.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Hello, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Ayushi, tell me.
Sir, can you get this PDF?
I think I've already shared this book with everyone. I think this.
No, sir, I didn't receive.
Okay, I'll do that. Just text me on my WhatsApp. I'll definitely share it with you.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone. Please take care.
You too, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.